So a lot of my work is just about the visual impact on you, and it doesn't have any specific meaning that I'm trying to portray. But I also have a lot of work where I'm trying to put some kind of social message out there, either it be civil rights or human rights, human sexuality, anti-war, politics. So sometimes, I think a lot of artists just paint what they're feeling at the moment, which does happen, but the ideas are usually something I really research and study. I think education is really important, and educating myself on what I'm trying to portray is really, to me, is really important. Important things to me in my art is having experiences, to be able to have experienced as much as I can so I can put that energy and those thoughts and the inspiration from them into my work. I've done everything from working hospice to working for Women's Spirituality magazine to being a yoga instructor to just a little bit of everything. So my son Walter has been the biggest influence on my career right now. He's really motivated me to inspired me to be better, to be successful, to leave a legacy for him. I really want him to see me being busy. I want him to see me creating beautiful work. I want to include him in that. I want to take him to shows with me. I want him to be part of it. I want to have him be surrounded by art and success. So yeah, he's my number one motivator.
Five years ago, myself, Alan Vandever, and Derek Hopkins started an art project and a book project. I painted 13 paintings about the child sexual abuse that I experienced as a child, and I narrated them to Derek, who copied them in his notes, and then between the two of us, we turned this into a book about Derek and I becoming survivors through our art. Through this process, we have created a not-for-profit called Childhood Fractured. Childhood Fractured works on preventing and ending child sexual abuse through contemporary art.
People are going to have to really grasp and wrap their brains around the fun aspect of it and, the playful act of art.
A little bit of a street art mentality in a bit because yeah. It's immediate. Like, either you're going to buy this or we're going to destroy it if you don't save it.
Yeah.
In Rescue and Destroy, I think it's a great project in terms of engaging people who aren't necessarily part of the art community. It's beyond just a gallery exhibition with Rescue and Destroy. Engage, they're doing things. They're not just talking to their friends, they're talking to
their friends. 150 going one time, 150 going twice, and rescue!
Is your passion, if art is the thing that you feel that you have to do, that I feel art is my life. I feel like everything in my art, my world, my son is my art, my wife is my art, my friend. I hope you follow us and continue to watch the rest of the journey, which I'm going to share with you.
especially you artists out there. Any questions about my art career that you want to ask, I will be happy to answer.
A lot of times artists, especially fine artists that are working full-time, they take their art just a little bit too seriously.